Dota 2 is a multiplayer team-based strategy game developed by Valve and distributed through the Steam Content Delivery Platform. At the beginning of a Dota match, each team typically buys one animal courier, whose purpose is to transport equipment from the base to each other player on the map. Much like cosmetic items for heroes, you can create and distribute your own custom courier through the Steam Workshop. In this series, we'll breathe life into a new courier by rigging it to a human IK skeleton. We'll then animate it using the Human IK Animation toolset, and then preview it in the game using Dota 2's import tools. Start off by setting your project folder to the provided scene files linked below, then open the file Dota 2 Courier Part 1 Start.mlt. We created this courier in accordance with the Dota Workshop technical guidelines. The game requires two models, one for the ground courier and one for the flying courier. For the scope of this tutorial, we'll use the same courier mesh for both models, but we'll animate it differently based on its state. Our courier is available in two resolutions. The LOD 1 version, designed for in-game use, is within the polygon count limitation of 3,000 triangles, while the LOD 0 version, designed for portrait views, includes 500 additional triangles in the head and face areas. Lastly, we've assigned a shader effects material displaying the necessary color, normal, and mask textures. This allows us to preview the courier's look in Maya LT as it would appear in-game. To create a basic skeleton framework for our courier, we'll use the Human IK Skeleton Generator controls. In the Animation menu set, go to Skeleton, Human IK. In the Character Controls Start pane, click the Create Skeleton button to generate a blank joint hierarchy. Rename it Courier. Turn on X-ray joints to see the skeleton on top of the courier, though it's still a little hard to see. To make it stand out even more, select Courier Hips, and in the Attribute Editor, go to the Display Drawing Overrides section. Turn on Enable Overrides, and drag the color slider to a desired color. This also affects all the child joints. Go to the Character Controls Definition tab. The character view displays the Human IK mapping structure of our joints, as well as their positions, rotations, and rotation orders. Right-click in the character view and go to Name Match View. In order to ensure solving accuracy, Human IK requires a mapping for these 15 joints. All joints highlighted in green are accounted for and are in accordance with the Human IK characterization requirements. You can find more information on these requirements in the Maya LT help. In addition, you can map other joints, such as more spine and roll joints, to accommodate your character's structure. However, these are optional to the Human IK characterization process. You should also note that according to the Dota Workshop technical guidelines, couriers have a limit of 52 joints. So it's best that we only keep the necessary joints, especially since we're also planning to create joints for the courier's face and propeller. Go back to the Skeleton tab. Since our courier differs a bit from the standard humanoid proportions, we'll need to make some adjustments. First, set the spine count to 1 to remove all optional spine joints, and set both neck count and shoulder count to 0 since our courier has neither a neck nor collarbones. Next, turn off all finger options except thumb and middle. Set finger joint count to 2 and enable finger base. This setup will allow the basic controls for this mitten hand. Similarly, turn off all the toe joint options except middle. Set the toe joint count to 1, and enable toe base. Once we're done configuring the skeleton, we can start repositioning each joint to its corresponding body part. Note that if you change your skeleton structure after repositioning it, the updates override your current pose with the default bipedal template. This is due to the connection between your character's HIK character node and HIK skeleton generator node. You can choose to delete the skeleton generator node to disable the skeleton generator from the character controls. To help quickly reposition the joints, we've included a set of reference locators. Let's start with the hips joint. Hold the V key to enable snap to points, then drag the joint to snap it to the matching hip locator under it. Do the same for the head joint. The resulting compressed spine accommodates our courier's head, while also abiding to the required human IK joint structure to ensure a proper solve later on. Repeat this process for the left arm and leg chains. Use the up and down arrow keys to travel the joint hierarchy. Make sure you only translate the joints into place. Don't rotate them, as we need their rotation channels to remain zeroed out. To adjust a single joint without affecting its children, press the Insert key to toggle pivot mode. At the end of the leg chain, delete the last toe joint since we won't be needing it. We're not going to worry about the right-sided chains for the moment, so we can delete them. In addition to the base human IK skeleton, we need to create some additional joint chains to control our courier's propeller and face objects. Duplicate the head joint and snap it to the propeller base locator. Create more duplicates for the remaining propeller components. Rename them Courier Propeller Base, Courier Propeller Arm, Courier Propeller Cover, Courier Propeller Blade, and Courier Propeller End. Parent them to create a single chain starting from the courier's spine. Note that while these new joints are connected to the main skeleton, Human IK ignores them as they are not part of the courier's skeleton definition. Next, duplicate the head joint again. Rename it Courier Faceplate 1. Create three more copies for the remaining faceplates, which are currently hidden. We'll be using these swappable faceplates in the next movie to change the background of our courier's face. Following the techniques covered so far, create a new two-joint chain for each of the left-sided face locators. This will allow us to rotate the eyes, eyebrows, and lips separately, following the curvature of the courier's face. Rename them according to their matching locator. Use the suffix end for the child joints to differentiate them from their parent. Parent all eight joint chains to the head joint, which we previously positioned at the center of the body. While we're at it, we can also add an extra joint to control the eye and eyebrow joints together, and another one to control all the lip joints. Go to Skeleton, Insert Joint Tool, and click the head joint in the workspace. Repeat this once more. Rename the joints Courier Eyes and Courier Mouth. Parent the eye and eyebrow joints to Courier Eyes and all the lip joints to Courier Mouth. We now have all the left-sided joints in place. Before we mirror them over to the right side, let's look at their local rotation axes, or LRAs for short. Select the entire skeleton hierarchy, then go to Display, Transform Display, Local Rotation Axes. All our joints' local axes are currently set to world space, which is usually a problem when creating custom rigs. Since the local rotation axes dictate the rotation plane each joint uses when rotating on a specific axis, setting them properly ensures that rotating along individual axes results in a single, isolated animation curve. This also results in consistent rotation values throughout each joint chain, such as an arm or a spine. However, the difference here is that we'll be animating our courier using a human IK control rig with pre-configured local rotation axes. So why would we bother with setting the local rotation axes on this skeleton if they are already set on the control rig? While it may not matter right now, it can impact the resulting animation curves when we bake our final animations from the courier's control rig back to its skeleton. And let's not forget the extra joints we created for the face and propeller. We need to set their local rotations, as they won't be part of the human IK control rig. For these reasons, we'll do a quick run-through to validate the local rotation axes. First, unparent the arm, leg, and propeller joint chains, as well as the face joints. Then, go to Skeleton Orient Joint Options. For the leg joint chain, we set the primary axis, which controls the roll, to X. The secondary up axis to Z, and world orientation to positive X, so the Z axis controls the leg's bend rotation. For the spine joints, we set the primary axis to X, secondary axis to Z, and world orientation to positive X. For the arm joint chain, the arm, hand, and fingers should bend around the Z axis. So set the primary axis to X, secondary axis to Y, and world orientation to negative Y. Note that to accommodate the thumb's rotation, you'll have to manually rotate the joint's local rotation axes. Click the Select by Component Type button, then select the Miscellaneous Components button. You can now directly rotate the thumb joint's local axes to line up with the geometry and ensure a consistent thumb rotation. For the remaining propeller and face joints, set the primary axis to X, secondary axis to Z, and world orientation to positive X. Reconnect the arm, leg, propeller, and face joints to their respective parent joints and turn off their local rotation axes display. To complete the skeleton, select the left arm joint and go to Skeleton Mirror Joint Options. Set Mirror Across to the YZ plane and Mirror Function to Behavior to reverse the joint's rotations without resulting in negative values. Enter Left and Right in the Search For and Replace With fields respectively. Click Apply. Repeat the mirror operation with the leg chain as well as the left-sided face joints. Let's do a final tally of our skeleton joints. Select the skeleton hierarchy and go to Display, Heads Up Display, Object Details. The total number of selected objects indicates that we're over the 52 joint limit imposed by the Dota 2 Workshop technical guidelines. However, since we're not going to use each joint chain's end joint, we can subtract them from our count. Additionally, if you display shapes in the outliner, you'll see that the reference locator's shape node is also counted. If we subtract it, we arrive within the joint limit. Go back to the Character Controls Definition tab. The Human IK validation status now flags an alert due to the fact that we haven't updated the skeleton definition with our new mirrored joints. Select a green-lit joint and click the Load Skeleton Definition button. This window lets you map all joints automatically using a naming template. Set template to the HIK naming convention and set match scope to all bones using the courier underscore prefix. The characterization becomes valid and is ready to be finalized. Click the Lock Skeleton Definition button to store the joint mapping, structure, and transforms to the skeleton definition. Note that you can finalize the characterization even with a yellow validation status, which usually indicates a warning in the alignment of your joints. In the next movie, we'll bind the courier mesh to this human IK skeleton and create a simple facial rig.